judges, what they call it, the baseline or the sideline on the centre service and short service.
16-19.
Welcome back, and as you can see on screen, from the Netherlands, Mark CALJOUW and Runa Massing just walking through the picture, coach for the Netherlands. And his opponent today, Yuhan Tan of Belgium. CALJOUW, the youngster from the Netherlands against the experienced Yuhan Tan. You can see on court, previous match, Lina Karsfeld won by walkover, not by retirement from Stephanie Stoiva.
Yuhan Tan, I heard that he was doing some heavy study, then stopped play a little bit, and now is he back on the court again?
No, he's actually doing more study, Rita. Oh, right. He's
his family all quite intelligent. They all doing quite.
Yeah, Leanne, his sister, is now a dentist, I think, also,
wow.
and Yuhan is studying medicine.
Wow.
So he spends a lot of the time on his internship at the moment.
So that's quite
in
hard.
The hospital.
Yeah.
Yep. And I interviewed him for the recent Badminton Europe magazine. There's an article there. You can have a good read of it later.
Okay.
And he's become a little bit frustrated. His results and his form is very inconsistent.
Okay.
Because he's effectively not able to practice as much as he would like to.
Yeah, that's quite hard. Yeah. Combination with the heavy study and the full-time badminton, obviously.
And there's one career that doesn't really mix with sport, and that's medicine, because it's so...
medicine, solicitor, dentist, all quite hard.
But a good performance yesterday from Yuhan in the opening round, and has beaten Mark CALJOUW before in the Turkey International in 2013. Won that one in two sets, but it was close in the second on that occasion, 23-21.
Yuhan Tan.
So Belgium. A little bit of history here between these two.
Yuhan Tan to serve, Lovell.
And
play.
This Dutch player, he's quite young, I guess.
CALJOUW, yeah. Junior of 2011. Got to the semi-final of the European Juniors. The same European Juniors that the young German Fabian Roth won at just 17 years of age.
So
Roth, who's just won and beaten Henry Hiskinen on one of the adjoining courts here at the men's... singles.
Service over. One all.
Mark CALJOUW beat an Austrian opponent in the first game, in the first round yesterday. And Yuhan Tan beat the now almost veteran Jan Frolik of the Czech Republic. 21-17, 21-16. Very good game that. A consistent game. A lot of highs and very few lows in that game for Yuhan Tan, and certainly he would have been very much happy with his performance.
I think to me, men's singles is quite important. You have a good training sparrow at home, then can bring
Three,
your level up.
One.
So I believe Mark is training at home with Eric Pan. So that would be quite good for him as well. Somebody you can aim it for.
Of course, Rudy Engels just pointing out to me while I mentioned the last match about Lina Karsfeld and Tia Madsen. And of course, Sandra Mia Jensen. We have Mia Blichfeldt, who's an up-and-coming player who won the Norwegian International recently. And certainly a real star of the future, the young Dane, who we'll see on court this week here in Glasgow. And also, we had the discussion about the how many clubs you could play for in Belgium this year also. And this year on, not allowed to play in two countries, you can only play in one. So a lot of countries seem to be moving.
One I think basically only. Just only one club.
Yeah.
If it's two club and with all those tournaments, it's quite hard for players.
So back to the match in hand. Good start for Yuhan Tan, 4-2.
Service over.
Of course, the Netherlands lost Erik Pang yesterday. Erik went out with a knee injury in his opening match. Have you spoken to him, Rita?
Yes, I spoke to him.
Is it bad? Is it good? Is
very
it
good, my friend. His knee's very bad.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a bit sore. He was first seat, then obviously he won. He said he won first set, and then second set he just feel he can't do anything.
He was winning. I was looking, and he was winning, and then all of a sudden the match was over, and I was wondering what happened, and I heard there was a knee issue. Do you know how long he may be out for, or does he just need maybe a few weeks?
I think he just need a few weeks.
Few weeks.
He said his knee been sore for quite a while, but he didn't know it's like that bad.
Okay.
So maybe a few weeks.
Serve's over. 4-5.
Nowadays, men's singles, I think, is quite hard to make on the quarter, whatever, quarter or semi-final. So the player must be like full-time training all the time.
Yeah, it's very difficult in men's singles. It's explosive power coming into the net from Yuhan.
6-4.
Just noticed sitting in the corner for Yuhan Tan as the men's doubles pair from Belgium. No Alan McIlvain, the Scottish coach, doesn't seem to be there. He was there yesterday, and I spoke to Alan last night. I don't see him in the coach's corner today.
I was thinking, yes, Alan should come because in Scotland.
Yeah, no, he was here yesterday. I saw him in the hotel last night, and no sign of him.
Today.
Unless there's somebody else from Belgium maybe coming out to play, and he will take that match maybe. Yeah.
Good smash. Very Red explosive.
Over. Really good smash, right on the line.
7-5.
That one just out. Very close. But good call from the line judge.
8-5.
So, Mark, do you think when they change to 11, is that quite different with the men's singles?
I love the 11. I love the 11 system. I've been to a few tournaments where it's been played.
Yes, just recently, isn't it?
Yes, I was at the Dutch Open, which was the highest level. It was played at a Grand Prix, and really enjoyed the 11. My big worry at the time, Rita, was would it suit doubles, men's doubles? Would it be too short?
But and the mixed doubles as
seven,
well, I think. Maybe.
Yeah, men's doubles worried me more so because it's maybe 1-2-3 bang, you know, rally over. But I saw some really good men's doubles matches that went, you know, to 1 hour with the new rules. So
with a 1 hour in 11 points?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So I think it suits the game, but that's purely my personal opinion. Mm-hmm.
Because I thought it would be very good for the attack player if it changed to 11 point. But I was just talking with the Petia earlier, and she said, really hard if you don't warm up after 4 or 5 points, and that's your finish.
Yep. So you have to come to the court ready.
Yeah.
Really, really ready.
Eight. Yeah. I just say to her, you must have a full game before you start.
Yeah.
When you do warm up, you do a full game outside, then you start playing.
You need to come onto the court sweating.
Uh huh. Yep. So, do you think it's going to be changed permanently or not really?
You know, I don't make rules. I talk about making rules and I write about making rules.
I think
I don't
we
make
can
rules.
All talk about yeah. keep talking.
But
I think it's interesting, like,
ten,
make a bit of change, eight. Make the sports more exciting.
I think the trial went well, from my personal opinion, and I think it worked in all the disciplines. And there was players who,
okay.
you know, didn't want it to happen, and then they played yep. it and experienced okay. it, and then liked it.
Yes.
And then there's other players who don't like it, and it seems to be very, very split down the middle. You know, 50-50.
Uh-huh.
So. But for me, it'll just be a question of adapting. You know, everyone will have to adapt.
Yes, exactly.
You know, me, most people know me around Europe, from Badminton Europe TV, and also as a photographer.
Uh-huh.
And even as a photographer,
the
matches become so short.
Uh-huh.
They have the potential to become short that we don't have time to photograph everything we need to photograph. So.
Exactly.
It'll mean a lot of adjustment for a lot of people, not just players, but organizers. Coaches will have to adjust the way of thinking and all these things.
Mm-hmm.
But as I was saying to Dan tonight, earlier, for me, the biggest issue with the new 11 system will be making sure that the line judging is excellent.
Yeah,
every point
is really serious. You can't make a mistake.
11-8, interval.
So that's where I can probably see a little bit of a problem. And back to the match. Yuhan Tan goes for the interval with a 3-point advantage, continuing from where he left off yesterday. And he's opening round. It was a good start for the Belgian.
Yuhan Tan's quite explosive player, look like. Smash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, got into an 8-5 lead. And Mark CALJOUW came right back at him, leveled it up at 8-all, and then 3 points in a row, and Tan has the interval lead once again. Certainly, if Yuhan can get by this round, he will feel he has a reasonable draw. Plays the winner of Lucas Clairbeau and Nick Fransman, which is on the adjoining court. Actually, Lucas Clairbeau, the Frenchman, has just won it. So the winner of our match will definitely play Lucas Clairbeau of France, which either player will think that they would have a real good chance of winning.
12.
And at that point, then you're into quarterfinals. And then it's when the competition really gets serious, and you've got the former winner, Anand Pavar of India.
Oh, that's
in this
quite
side
hard.
Of the draw, yeah.
Quite hard to draw. Quite hard games.
13.
But if you make a quarter, I think that would be quite good the result as well. Grand Prix Open.
Just one final comment on the scoring system, Rita, you were asking, and we were discussing it there, and not to really dwell on it too longer,
so
but
it's over.
A lot of people talk about, do you need
9,
setting
13. Mm-hmm.
in it, and I certainly would not be for setting unless it goes to the fifth game.
Right.
So, yeah, 11, 10-all, 10-all, then next point wins, but if it goes to the final game, then
set
to 15.
Setting. Yes. Set to 15.
Yeah. That's just my opinion. Mm-hmm. That's what I think would work.
So, if it's over. 14-9.
So, again, a good spell for Yuhan Tan, leading 15-9. And this is the second round of the men's singles here at the Scottish Open Grand Prix. And Yuhan's showing some 16. Form and signs Show of it yesterday.
Showing attack is a really good attack, Yuhan Tan.
Yeah, good explosive attack, yeah. Rita. Can really come forward quickly. And a lot of power in that smash, the left-handed Belgian. Just out.
So
2015 will be a big 60. Year for Belgian badminton, hosting the men's, the mixed team championships.
The mixed team championship, yeah. That was, I look on the line, Badminton Europe, there's like kind of advertising so for the badminton
17.
championship 10. In the Belgium. It's quite fun. Quite interesting.
Oh, they made a lovely, cool video. Yeah. Have you seen that?
Yeah. I don't know if you see that. I think that's quite interesting.
Yeah, they put a lot of effort and are really good at organising events in Belgium, as is borne out by their Belgian international every year.
11,
probably one of the best international
17.
Challenges on the circuit, if not the best. Mm-hmm. Belgian, along with the French international, is another seriously good international. And this new Swedish one international up in Uppsala. Has the potential to be a really good tournament, I think.
Yes, okay. Just say about the championship. 2017 is what championship in Glasgow, isn't it? I think that's very good.
18.
For
11.
You want to come back for that?
I think if I come back, I don't know what happened with the Scotland junior players. So, no, there's Panting Juniors come up, so no me.
Yeah, it's going to be another big year for Scottish badminton, hosting the World Championships in 2017. Just announced the day before yesterday, of course, and with the Sudirman Cup going to the
18.
Gold Coast in Australia.
Gold Coast, yes.
Super for badminton. Australia getting their turn, and judging from their Super Series recent, you know, their, and their organisation of that event and Mate. Their Grand Prix, and really sure to do a good job.
Say Australia, I don't think Australia have been organized a really big event like World Championship, Sudirman Cup, like for long, long time. Because I remember one of the year I was playing, I hardly go to Australia apart from Melbourne,
19,
that's Commonwealth Games.
12.
I don't ever go to there. Because all the time World Championship or Sudirman Cup always like China or Europe.
Yep.
Don't go to that part of the world.
Yeah, but it's important 13, to spread it out, isn't 19. It? Spread the love.
Yeah, I think that's very good for badminton to all over the world.
A little bit of indecision from Mark Calhoun. Had to look at that twice before playing it.
20. Game point.
Yuhan
13.
Tan anticipating the short return all over at the net, taking the Belgian to game point.
Quite comfortable in the first set.
Yeah, very comfortable in the end, Rita, winning at 21-13.
First game and, won by Yuhan Tan, 21-13.
The best Mark Calhoun could do was when he got it even terms at 8-all, and it's been pretty much all Yuhan Tan since that. At 8-all, Yuhan went on to win 8 from 9 points, and really no looking back from there.
Mm-hmm. And Mark is quite young, is it?
Yes. I think Mark is probably 18 or 19.
Oh.
He played in the European Juniors in Ankara in Turkey in 2000. And 11, yeah. No, in 2013. So, yeah, still probably just 18 years of age.
Okay. So still panting room to get on.
And from my memory, he got to the semi-final.
In the European Junior Championship?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not too bad, the result. So you're talking about badminton Europe, magazine. Where do you get that? Do you get online or...?
Yes, you can find it online on the Badminton Europe website.
Uh-huh.
You just click into Badminton Europe and the magazine is normally there. I write some articles for it and the guys in the office put it together. And
Then you just can read online Badminton Europe, is it? Oh, okay. I will have a look.
Service over. 1-1.
good net to return from Yuhan Tan.
2-1. Service over. 2-2.
Right idea, the smash down the line, but a long
Service
way
over.
Out. You could see Mark turning to his coach, Runanasing, holding his hands in the air, just not going right for him at the moment.
Good smash from Yuhan Tang again.
4-2.
Come on.
5-2.
Once again, if you're watching, don't forget to use the Twitter hashtag SOGP if you want to make a comment, if you want to ask a question. Nothing really happening for Mark CALJOUW in this game.
6-2.
Yuhan Tan looking like a confident player once again.
Confidence, and also I think Yuhan Tan's looking much more faster, speed level.
Oh.
And the keep changes, like drop, smash, closer, flexer. Kind to me, the Mark doesn't know how to do.
Yeah, some really good variety from Yuhan. That time, a better smash onto the back of Yuhan Tan from Mark CALJOUW.
Service over. 3-7.
Again, Yuhan Tan really reading the game well, anticipating the short return from CALJOUW.
So, training, when did he say training? Like if he's doing study and a work?
He has very, very little time to train, Rita, and and that's the frustrating part from him, because you know, as an athlete, you all, you know, when you're an athlete,
you want training, rest, and then training again.
And also your mindset is that of winning, winning. And then if you're not training and you're competing and you're not winning, you get frustrated and things just don't go well. But he's playing quite well yesterday for sure, and again here today. It'll be interesting to see, will Yuhan, and I never asked him this question, but it'll be interesting to see, will he manage, or has he got the ability to put another Olympic campaign? Can he fit it into his studies?
Oh, right. So is he looking for go to 2016?
I don't know. I have to ask him that question. But like, he's still here and he's playing, so why else would you be playing? You know, unless you really...
You have a goal, is it?
Exactly. That's a nice stick smash from Mark CALJOUW.
7-8. Mark, shuttle.
Yeah, good deceptive shot.
Service over. And
shot down into the forehand corner.
9-7.
Looked like Yuhan was going to play a little net spin and then pushed it down into the deep forehand corner. CALJOUW had already moved forward and then had to switch and go backwards again.
I think in the singles player, like men's singles or even ladies singles, it's important you have a good net. So like, then you can get a lot of opportunity if you have a good net.
10, 7.
So I remember when I was young, we're training on net, a lot of net shot. Every day with a box of net, to just a practice net shot.
11, 7, interval.
And that lift from CALJOUW just drifting over the baseline. And it's the end of a lead yet again for Yuhan Tan, 11-7, pretty much as it was in the first game. And the Belgian number one already won, set up, winning the first 21-13. 22 minutes gone in this men's singles second round, of course, the Scottish Open Grand Prix, round of 64 in the men's singles. So these men already won round behind them yesterday evening.
So is every Grand Prix there's no qualification, or is it just only for Scottish?
Court one, 20 seconds, some, court one, 20 seconds.
Because I noticed this is no qualification for the men's singles, is it? Yes. Oh, right,
yes,
sorry.
Yes, there was qualification. It just depends on the size of the draw, whether they go for 32 or 64.
11-7.
Okay.
That's another thing that would be certainly my preference. If the new system, scoring system, came in, would be to shorten qualification, because I think if you have played three games in qualification, you're very, very tired by the time you come to a first round.
Then you got hammered by first seat or
something. Yeah, yeah, or something like this. And then what is the point in that? Maybe one round of qualification, just 8 players.
Yeah.
Which you need, because you need players that you might need to promote to the main draw anyway. So. And have that just before the first round starts.
Yes. So,
and then it pushes down the players who shouldn't be at this level, down to the level they should be at, which makes the other tournaments better.
Yes.
So,
I think to look at some like tournaments, like some challenge tournament, but qualifications is massive.
Oh, it's
you
crazy.
Like play a mini tournament before you start to get in the main draw.
Exactly. It's it's crazy, really.
Service over.
Now I was talking with some players. They always said that they're always in the qualification and meet some like Far Eastern player. Even it's harder in the main draw.
Service over. 9-14.
Matt, because it seemed like get back the game a little bit.
Yeah, still 5 points behind, and that's a poor shot from Yuhan. And that's the shot of
10-14.
A guy who's not practicing that much, or not practicing as much as he would like to. It's important for Yuhan that he just keeps going, keeps focused, because he's pretty much controlled this match. And if he gives Mark CALJOUW the opportunity to come back, you know, the young Dutchman will certainly seize that opportunity. Well, that's
so
a good shot from the Belgian.
15.
Of course, a little bit of local rivalry always, the Netherlands against Belgium. That's like Scotland against England, you know.
Is it? All right.
Oh, great defense from Yuhan Tan. Somehow managing to dig the shuttle out of his body. Nice drop from Mark CALJOUW.
Service over.
Good net again.
11-15.
Equally good defense from the Dutchman. Yuhan just pushing CALJOUW back.
That's a bit unlucky. It was a very good opportunity from Mark.
16-11.
Over.
17.
Good serve. And then following
11.
It up at the net from Yuhan Tan. Commanding position now for the Belgian. That one was out also.
Mistake again. Still young, 11. There's quite a few opportunity, but end up he make a mistake. So I think more training he will be better.
Yeah. But that's a super cross net from Yuhan Tan.
11.
Ah, and the error and the smash with heavy slice.
20, match point, 11.
And match point in just 27 minutes for Yuhan Tan.
Service over. 12, 20.
See Yuhan sensing the short net return and moving forward. And this time,
game.
Yuhan Tan manages to secure the point that he needs to win. Convincing, very convincing from the Belgian number one, 21-13, 21-12. But a good
match
potential
by Yuhan Tan,
in young Mark CALJOUW, just out of juniors. He's frustrated.
12.
And that's good to see sometimes.
Yeah.
When these kids, you know, these young guys, you know, they're unhappy that they've lost, and you know, that's good because they have to deal with losing.
Yeah, I think he will go home training hard and then come back again next year. I think he will be different.
Exactly, and he's a very focused young man, and takes his badminton really serious, and big future for him, of course.
Let's see you next year.
The winner, and you'll see the final rallies, and Yuhan Tan letting the shuttle just drift over the baseline, and both players leave the court. Tan, who progresses to the next round, we'll take a short break and we'll be back then shortly with it's a men's doubles and Robert Blair alongside Adam Hall against English duo Conor Bambrick and Thomas Joseph Stanford.